So in our next lesson, we're going to start controlling LEDs using software. This will allow us to blink this LED or turn it on and off at will instead of just having it hardwired and always on. So you can see here, I have the LED instead of being wired just between the power and ground buses with the current limiting resistor, one side of it goes to one of the Arduino's digital pins. So in order to control the LED with the Arduino, we need to do two things. We need to tell the Arduino that we want to use this pin as an output, and then we need to set that pin high or low to 5 volts or 0 volts, depending on whether we want the LED on or off. So to do this, you'll need to use the code window. Again, make sure you've remembered to switch over to the text editor and not the blocks editor. Now, if you've used an Arduino before, this might look a little different to you. In these lessons, we are not going to be using the Arduino libraries, so you won't see commands like pin mode, which allows you to set the pin to an input or an output, or digital write, which allows you to set the pin high or low. Again, we're not going to be using those, so you won't see them here, but the general setup for the code is the same. Conceptually, we have setup code that only runs once, and then we have an infinite while loop. So the condition for this while loop is 1, which is just always true. So the code inside this while loop will then run forever. So to blink an LED, which is kind of like the hello world equivalent of physical computing, we want to have some setup code here that tells the Arduino we're using that pin as an output, and then we want code here that just alternates turning the LED on and off. So you can see that right now, if I run my simulation, not surprisingly, nothing happens. So this is just empty code that is looping forever but not doing anything. I haven't set this pin as an output or turned it on, so the LED is still off. So in order to control the LED, we're going to introduce something called registers. We have two registers in this program, DDRD and PortD. Again, if you are used to Arduino code, you would probably expect a pin mode command here and a digital write command here. So these registers are serving the same function, but not using the Arduino libraries. Now, we're not going to go into a ton of detail on what exactly a register is. These are special locations in the processor's memory where you can set individual bits to 1 or 0. And many of these registers have special functions that are related to the specific microprocessor and its hardware. In this case, these two registers serve the functions of setting these pins as inputs or outputs, and then setting them high or low if they are set as an output. So in this case, for the DDR, which stands for data direction register, by default, all of these bits are 0, but if you set one of them to 1, that will make the corresponding pin an output. Similarly, for the port register, by default, all of these bits are 0, which sets the pins to low or 0 volts, but if you set a bit to 1, that will set the corresponding pin high or to 5 volts. So you can see now I have code here that is setting a pin as an output because I set one of these bits to 1, and then I am turning that corresponding pin high by setting the bit to 1. So now if I run this code, the LED will just turn on and stay on. And that's great, but you've probably noticed that I skipped over something here. I have 13 digital input and output pins in my Arduino, and 8 bits in each of these registers. How in the world do I know which bit corresponds to which pin? So I'm using pin 7 on the Arduino. What does that have to do with which bit I set to 1 in each one of these registers? Now, that is where an Arduino pinout diagram like this one is going to come in very handy. Now, this looks completely overwhelming at first. It is totally covered in numbers and acronyms. I'm going to ask you to just ignore all of them except this column of yellow acronyms and numbers here that we're going to zoom in on. So we have our physical Arduino pins labeled 0 through 13 here, and each one of these pins corresponds to a port. The Atmega328P has 3 ports, port B, port C, and port D. Each one of those ports has 8 bits associated with it. So port D is probably the easiest because the bit numbers in the port correspond to the physical pin number on the Arduino. So for example, we are using pin 7, which is port D bit 7. So if we go back to my code, now here's another important thing about registers that I skipped over before. If you're used to programming in MATLAB, this can take some getting used to. For an 8-bit register, you start counting on the right, and the bits are numbered starting at 0. So don't get this mixed up with a MATLAB array where you would start counting on the left and the first entry would be indexed at 1. So this is 8 bits, but they go from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the 7th bit. So to set Arduino pin 7 as an output and then turn it high, I use the DDRD register, write a 1 to the 7th bit, which again, according to this diagram, corresponds to pin 7. And then to set that pin high, I use the port D register and again, set the 7th bit to 1. So that is setting pin 7 as an output and then setting it high, which will turn the LED on. Now, it's always good practice to comment your code, so I've added comments here explaining that I am setting pin 7 as an output and then setting pin 7 high. Our goal was to blink the LED, not just turn it on and leave it on, so I'm going to add delay commands. Delay MS sets a delay in milliseconds, so 1000 milliseconds will delay for 1 second, and then I would like to turn the LED back off, which I can do by setting the corresponding bit back to 0. Then adding one more delay command to keep the LED off for a second. And now when I run this, I have my first program that kind of does something. It just turns the LED on and off in intervals of 1 second. Now, one quick note about registers before we move on to the assignment for this lesson. Again, this isn't really an intro to programming course, but I want to mention something that can be kind of a matter of personal preference for how you write to these. The 0B here is how you specify a binary number in C. Some people like to write it all out like this because then you can really think about how each bit that's either a 0 or 1 corresponds to a physical pin. Some people hate writing it like that and think it's too easy to lose track of which bit you're on and prefer to use something called bit shifting, which I'm not going to explain in detail in this video, but you'll see here that I can comment out this line and run this with the bit shifting code instead, which is telling it to shift the bit 1/7 spaces in the register. So when I run that, it functions exactly the same. So this line is equivalent to this line. Alternatively, you can also just write it as a decimal number. So the binary number 1 and followed by 7 zeros is equivalent to the decimal number 128. So if you wanted to, you could also just write DDRD equals 128, and this will also run. You're probably not going to want to do that in this case, but that will come in handy later when we are working with timers, which we won't talk about for a few more videos. So your assignment for this video is to add another LED on port B, which is pins 8 through 13. So if you go back to the Arduino pinout diagram, you'll see we have pins 8 through 13 that are labeled PB0 through PB5. So you have to be a little more careful here because the port bit number does not match up to the physical Arduino pin number. So Arduino pin 8 is port B bit 0. Arduino pin 13 is port B bit 5. So that's not as convenient as port D where the bit numbers line up with the pin numbers. So again, your assignment is to wire another LED the same way you have this one wired, but do it on port B and then have that LED blink in unison with this one.